In the last set of slides, we analyzed the polarization, the y direction for the electric field and the xz direction for the magnetic field. This time we're going to look at the direction of propagation for each of these fields. So I'm going to write the direction of propagation up here as a vector, and then I'm going to use it down here as a phase delay term for my magnetic and my electric fields. So let's write each of these using geometry. Let's write the unit vector ki that represents the direction of propagation for the incident field. We can see that that is going in the z direction with a cosine of theta, and in the positive x direction with a sine of theta. So this is x sine of theta I plus z cosine of theta I. Now let's look at the reflected field. The reflected field also has a z component, but you can see that's negative. And it has an x component, which is also positive. So kr is going to have a positive x component. Let's look at that. Here's the direction of x. So that is sine of theta r plus, minus its z term, cosine of theta r. The next one we want to look at is the transmitted field. Here we have the z direction. We can see that's going to be in the cosine, and we have a positive x direction, that is sine. So our transmitted vector is positive x sine of theta t plus z cosine of theta t. I want to point something out to you just to make your life easier. Note that the incident and the transmitted vectors are approximately the same. They are exactly the same, in fact, both being positive x, positive z, except for the fact that this is theta I and this is theta t. Did that happen for the polarization too? Check this out. Here's the incident and the transmitted magnetic fields. Look at these two vectors. They are the same except for the actual angle, the actual numeric value of this angle. So that's going to just make your life easier as you go through here. Now, let's take these directions of propagation, and let's put them over as a propagation vector for the magnetic field. First, let me remind you what happened when we had a vector that was propagating into the z direction normally. So here is one, here is two. Here's a normally incident plane wave. Remember, if we wanted to write that plane wave, such as the electric field, let's put the electric field just like this, and let's suppose this was normally incident. In this case, we would write this electric field as having some magnitude, the y polarization, just as we did before, and then we would have written e to the minus j beta z. That would have been the term that represented the phase propagation in this direction. Now, there are two things that we're going to change here. One is beta. Instead of calling it beta, we're going to call it constant k. K and beta are really the same thing. K is omega square root of mu epsilon. If we're in material number one, such as we are here, this would be beta 1, so it would be K1, so it would be mu and epsilon. Make a note that this mu includes mu naught, and the epsilon includes epsilon naught. So there's the constant that we're going to be using for propagation. And then take a look at this z. Z means we're going in just the z direction, but this time we're not going in just the z direction, we're going in the k direction. So I'm going to take this k term and I'm going to substitute it for this z term. Let me show you how that's going to work. I'm going to do it here on the magnetic field because we've got a little more space. So it's going to be e to the minus j k, and I'm in region number one, and then I need to put in something for z. So instead of z, I'm going to put in this value. Now this is not actually a vector. This is a vector. Sorry, this incident field is a vector. But this is not. This is a dimension, a direction, a number of meters. So if I just take the hat off my x, sine of theta I, and I take the hat off my z, cosine of theta I have the direction of propagation represented right here. So this is my complete expression for the magnetic field, except that I still need to do the magnitude. And then it's the same thing going to happen for my reflected field. I'm still in region number one. Let's go look at the reflected field vector. Let's take off the hats. Let's substitute it in here. So this is going to be x sine of theta r minus z cosine of theta r. Now let's come to the transmitted one, e to the minus j k, but this time I'm in region number 2. Now let's go find the transmitted direction of propagation, and let's take off the hats and substitute it in here. It is going to be x sine of theta t plus z cosine of theta t. Now exactly these same terms, this term right here is the incident term, this term right here is the reflected term, and this term right here is the transmitted term. These come up with our electric field vector. So I literally copy my incident field propagation term and I put it up here. I find my reflected field propagation term and I put that up here. And I find the transmitted field propagation term and I put it up there. Let's also look at what this term means. This term has a J in it. So this is representing the phase. I'm going to put arrows there so that you don't think I'm dividing by phase. This is representing the phase shift as I go through propagation. It's phase shift due to propagation. This right here is called the propagation constant, and this is the direction of propagation. So I end up with a phase term. Let's review. This is the polarization term, and that's telling us about the vector, how the vector is lined up. I want to mention one more thing on the polarization term. If I have an electric field that is polarized, as this one is, into or out of the board, I'm going to pick that up or transmit that with an electric, with a piece of metal, a wire, that is oriented in this direction. If my electric field had been lined up this way, I would pick that up with a piece of wire in this direction. If I have a magnetic field that is out of the board, I'm going to pick that up with a loop antenna that's going to go around it like so. And if I had it oriented more in this direction, my loop antenna would have to go around the magnetic field. So far what we have looked at is the polarization of the magnetic and electric field and the transmission phase shift, transmission propagation, that happens for both the magnetic and the electric fields. The last part of this problem is to analyze the magnitudes of these magnetic fields and these electric fields. So that's the last thing we're going to be doing.